Welcome to the campus of University of the District of Columbia, basketball fans, as the Glenville State Pioneers take on your University of D.C. Columbia Firebirds. Now, this is going to be a tough game for UDC, as Glenville State is averaging almost 98 points per game, which is almost unfathomable in Division II women's basketball. Now, UDC only averages about 50 points per game, so they're definitely going to have to slow down the pace if they want to keep up with this red-hot Pioneers basketball club. The Pioneers are coming off a win over UVA Wise in their home opener, 103-78, so they are absolutely rolling right now. UDC got their first win in conference last week when they beat Damon College 56-54 here at UDC. UDC is led by Naysia Anderson, who is scoring 12 points per game. She's definitely going to have to carry the program today, because if you're going to have to keep up with scoring 98 points per game, your best shooter is going to have to be on point, because when it comes to the Pioneers, they can hit you from all sides. They have four people, at least, possibly five. We're not sure about the stats on the other goal yet, but they have at least four people that are averaging double-digit scores, while UDC only has about two or three. So they can hit you from all angles. Glenville State is 5-1, and they are 3-1 in the Mountain East Conference, and they are located in Glenville, West Virginia. So it's not too far of a trip for them, so they shouldn't have too much bus lag now. But UDC is definitely going to have to be on top of their game, because they have fallen to 2-5 outside of the conference, and they're going to have to pick up a marquee win if they're going to have any chance of making the tournament without winning the East Coast Conference.
Thanks, Brian. I'm here with assistant coach Jerisha Obi. Jerisha, this team averages 97.7 points per game. So my first question is, how do you slow them down?
I mean, we have to stop them in transition. You know, we're going to check the cutters. We're going to try to do our half-court, full-court press and just kind of slow the tempo down a little bit, make sure they don't get layups. I mean, in practice, we've been telling them to get back in transition, point and talk, find a man, guard the basket. Don't just look for your man. But the biggest thing is just getting back and stopping them in transition.
What do you look to do offensively today?
We want to spread the floor, get wide and get deep, get our players like Naysia going, get her off a little bit, get her scoring early. Pretty much move without the ball. Don't stand. Pass, cut, get open shots in the corner, in the wing. Just make sure we have a lot of ball movement, you know, play together as a team.
And what did you see from the team on Saturday in your first win over Damon, and how do you look to repeat that today?
We made shots. I mean, previously we were a little bit of a shooting slump. We weren't shooting as well as we wanted to shoot, but on Saturday, we played as a team and we made shots. Biggest thing, you know, everybody contributed. You know, Chantrell stepped up huge for us. Naysia stepped up huge. So everybody did their job. You know, again, we knocked down open shots that we've been trying to do all season. So,
all right, well, best of luck today.
Thank you.
All right, I'm here with Glenville State head coach Kim Stevens. Kim, you guys are 5-1 going into this game. You averaged 97.7 points per game. How do you do all your scoring?
We shoot a lot. We want to shoot 100 times a game, and we want almost half of those to be threes. So we look to shoot, we look to force tempo, and pretty much everyone on our team has a green light.
What have you seen from the Firebird squad on film?
They're long, they're athletic. They're going to be one of the more athletic teams we face so far. So, you know, we press a lot and we like to play fast, and this team is going to be able to keep right up with us. And so it'll be a test for us.
All right, thank you very much. Good luck today.
Firebirds fans, we are about ready to go here from the campus of the University of the District of Columbia, where your Firebirds are about to take on the Glenville State Pioneers. And Glenville State will start with the ball. as number 12, Paris McCloy, dribbles up the court. Passes to Disrocher, dribbles over, back to McCloy. Back to Disrocher. McCloy for a deep three, no good, rebound. Back to McCloy, drives, dribbles, puts it up and layup, no good. Shot was attempted by court number 10, Courtney Davis. She is fouled on the way up, going for two. Courtney Davis is a 40% free throw shooter from the line today, this year. Making the free throws are going to be key in this game. Second one goes up, and it is good. Starting off today with a 2-0 score for Glenville State. Nyasia Anderson goes up court. Kaya Coleman. Coleman passes to Chantrell Oliver. She brings it back out midcourt. And the pass is stolen away by Glenville State. And they will bring it back out. Disrocher for a three, and it is good. 5-0, Glenville State. Glenville State incorporating the full court pressure, but they break it. Goes down to number 5. And looks like there is a hold on Glenville State's number 32, Brittany Jackson. Coming into the game for Glenville State, number 23, Tyana Stewart, and number 33, Caitlin Wilson. Also number 0, Trussell Odyssey. Inbound pass goes all the way behind midcourt line as Chantrell Oliver takes it up. Dribbles, cuts through the lane, gets stripped, and stolen away. Coming down is McCloy. Layup is no good. Rebound. Coming down the court, Chantrell Oliver for a layup, and it's good. And there's your first point of the day for the Firebirds. With 8 minutes left here in the first quarter. Glenville State goes up for a three, no good. Rebound by number 5, Nyasia Anderson. Brings it all the way up the court. Gives it to Kaya Coleman for three, no good. Rims out. Glenville State's about to bring in 5 subs coming into the game, so they're going to have a brand new 5. Oh. Anderson brings it up the court. Anderson's three is no good. Rebound by number 21, Rollins. Nyasia Anderson with another layup. And she has both of their points today. Three-pointer, no good by Glenville State. Rebound goes to Chantrell Oliver. Firebirds are getting some offensive rebounds here today, which is going to be key in slowing down the Pioneers' attack. Oh, stolen away and an easy transition layup for number 12, Paris McCloy. And it is a 7-4, Glenville State lead. Glenville State is utilizing full court pressure. UDC breaks it. And it's a three, no good, off the front iron. McCloy brings it down for Glenville State. Passes it to number 0. She puts up a 3. No good. Rebound, Kaya Coleman. Timeout. Timeout for Glenville. Correction. Full timeout, UDC. UDC is able to get those offensive rebounds, which is going to be key in this game because Every time Glenville misses, they're going to have to scoop it up. Glenville is known for their high-scoring offense. They have had 98 points scored on average this year. So UDC is going to have to take advantage of those missed shots by Glenville, because you know they're going to start making them eventually. Glenville State's got that full court pressure going on every time UDC inbounds the ball. You're going to be very careful with and avoid sloppy play, because any turnovers in your offensive in your defensive zone could be killer to a momentum swing. Deja Anderson to inbound the ball for the Firebirds. Gets it in, breaks the full court press. Niaja Anderson with another layup. She has all 6 points today for the Firebirds as they climb within one. Glenville State puts up a three. It's an air ball. No good. Rebound by number 10, Courtney Davis, is up, and it is good. 9-6, Pioneers. Niaja Anderson bringing down the court. Knocked out of bounds. Firebirds will retain possession. 5:58 left here in the first quarter as the Pioneers are leading 9-6 over the Firebirds. There's an inbounds. Goes to Chantrell Oliver. Brings it across to the right side. Kaya Coleman brings it back. Dishes it back out to Chantrell Oliver. Waiting for something to open up. Kaya Coleman gets it. Back to Oliver for three. Air ball. And recovered by the Pioneers. Taken down by Rayana Marshall. Rayana Marshall puts it up for three. Air ball, no good. Rebound by number 11, Niana Tunstall, and she is fouled. Good second effort by Tunstall. Oh, correction, by Erica Toney. Erica Toney will be at the line shooting two. Toney is a 55% free throw shooter on the year. First one is up. Bounds around the rim and goes. And Glenville State will be bringing in another five subs, excluding the one that's coming in for the shooter, Toney. But they keep their players fresh. They have a good rotation going on. They rotate five of their players at a time, which will definitely be key as we wind down this game. Second free throw is no good, grabbed by number 21, Jasmine Rollins. And now the press break is on. Ooh, almost went back court there, but they got away with it. Kaya Coleman puts up a 20-foot jumper. She gets bailed out by a foul underneath by number 33, Kaylin Wilson. Coming into the game for Glenville State, number 5, Cher Davis. You may hear me say Davis a lot. They have three of them on their team today. Nice floater by Niaja Anderson. She is on fire today. Kristen DeRocher. Puts out the three, no good. Coming down the court is Chantrell Oliver. She breaks away. Nice pass to Deja Anderson. Anderson has scored all of the points for UDC as of now. And it is now 10-10. And we have a traveling violation on Glenville State on Trussell. And yet again, five Pioneers are coming out to sub in for Glenville State. Well, when you have so many proven scorers, you can do this. You can have five people come in all at once. Nice pass up the court. Deja Anderson, get it? No, correction, Niaja Anderson with the basket. The two Anderson girls are really, the two Anderson girls are the ones that are being able to keep them in this game. Long three by number one, Maya Horn of Glenville State. It kind of died on the back of the rim, but somehow it fell in, and they have taken a 13-12 lead here with 3:45 left in the first quarter. Chantrell Oliver. Press coverage, and there's a foul. I didn't see anything there, but they're getting Maya Horn on the foul for Glenville State. Coming into the game for UDC, number 11, Diana Tunster. Aisha Anderson will inbound. Goes to Chantrell Oliver. Traveling violation on Bianca White. And Glenville State will bring in a fresh five. Glenville State have the depth, and they have proven that they can sub in people and have no, they can have no delay. They can just go right into their offense. Nice rebound by number 23, Stewart. And the Pioneers take a 3-point lead. That's an obvious foul right there. You can't run into someone who has the ball and then just throw your hands up and expect that the refs aren't gonna call it. Silly foul there. McCoy brings it up, past the midcourt line. Brings it to Schrocher. Odyssey Trussell with a three. And now a 6-point lead for Glenville State. UDC is getting good fast break opportunities. And throws it right to number five, Niaja Anderson, for another easy bucket. UDC is definitely able to break that fast, that get off on fast breaks. If they can break the full court press, they will have a shot in this game. Bianca White puts it up, no good, but there is a foul. Foul will be on number zero for Glenville State, Odyssey Trussell. Bianca White at the line shooting two. She's only a 55% free throw shooter, and she misses the first. I have never seen such a turnstile of players on the bench and players playing on the court for Glenville State here. Every 3 or 4 minutes, they bring five fresh bodies into the game. That's going to be key when it gets late in the crunch time and UDC may be tired, and Glenville State has just been continuously pulling people in at a steady clip. Kaylin Wilson has the ball. 3-second violation, it looks like, on Glenville State. And that will go to UDC, and Deja Anderson will bring it in. Full court pressure, tried to get trapped in the corner, breaks it. Long pass over to Bianca White. Passes it to Niaja Anderson, who dribbles, takes a layup, and it's good! Niaja Anderson, yet again. She is putting UDC on her back today. And they're down by only one. Three-pointer by Asiah Smith is no good. Rebound put up by Courtney Davis, and she is fouled on the shot. And she will go to the line, shooting two more. UDC's foul was on number 15, Chantrell Oliver. Looks like the cheerleaders might have had some part in that one as he misses the first one. As soon as she was about to shoot that shot, UDC got their Firebird chance going on over there in the corner, and it might have worked. I don't know if that was planned, but it was genius by UDC's cheerleading coach. Going for two. And she misses both of them. Courtney Davis is not a good free throw shooter, but there it's stolen again. Three-pointer by Odyssey Trussell, no good. Rebound by Disrocher. And back out to Disrocher for three, and she hits it. 21-17, Glenville State. As they full court pressure, Trapper in the corner, they break it. Coming down the court is Nyasia Anderson. Puts up for three. It's good for three. Bianca White for a three-pointer and has cut the lead to 121-20. Tiana Stewart with the ball, passes it over to McLeod. Has it in Slosher. Cannot find anything out front. Has it down low. Puts up a scoop shot, no good. Rebound by Deanna Tunstall. Nyjie Anderson bringing it up the court. Got 12 seconds. Oh, risky pass, but it pays off. As Jasmine Rollins goes up for the layup. And it's no good, but there is a foul. Foul is on number 0, Odyssey Trussell for the Pioneers. Jasmine Rollins is at the line, shooting 2. It's up. It is good. Jaslyn Rollins, only a 41% free throw shooter, makes her first. And we are all tied up here at UDC, 21 apiece. Free throw's up. No good. 7 seconds left, and McCloy is bringing it down the court. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. McCloy puts up a desperation, and it is blocked by Bianca White. And that's the end of the first quarter. And a surprisingly tied ball game. UDC 21, Glenville State 21.
We're building an advanced public system of higher learning that serves the community of the District of Columbia. We selected all of those words very carefully because they all have important meanings. Because none of it really works unless you have a public higher education system that can connect it all together. Well, one of the best kept secrets about the University of the District of Columbia is that we have many quality programs. Our workforce development unit is of a high quality and puts people in jobs each and every day. Our land grant unit, which is serving constituents all over the district, we're the only urban land grant institution in the country. I think that we have all the pieces that we can put together in a way that will allow us to take best practices, best tools, and really wipe the slate clean and redesign ourselves as an advanced public system of higher learning that can serve the district in a way that allows us to be a model of higher education in a city that wants to be a model city for the rest of the country.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Coach Juan Dixon has got to be happy with the way his UDC Firebirds are playing right now as they are tied 21-21 going into the second quarter. UDC has only averages about 50 points per game, and they've almost reached the halfway point to their season average already here after one quarter. Ty Cullen puts up the layup, it is no good. Rebound by McCloy. She dribbles it down, stripped away, tried to get in there. Nice pass to Tiana Stewart for the easy layup. 23-21, Glenville State. Asia Anderson brings it up the court, gets it past the midcourt line. Nice pass down. Nice steal, but gotten back by UDC. Puts up the shot. Ooh. There is a foul underneath as Jaslyn Rollins was going up for the rebound. Odyssey Trussell took her down hard. I don't know if that was intentional or not. But Rollins took a spill right underneath the basket, and that has gotta hurt. But she's staying in there. So she's a tough sport. So in front of their baseline goes all the way back behind Firebirds logo. Ty Coleman brings it up. Glenville State playing a 2-3 zone. Risky pass, and it's stolen away by Glenville State. Pass up the court, and the layup is good by Brittany Jackson. And it is a 4-point lead for the Pioneers. They do not let up on the full court press, but UDC has been able to get past, and I spoke too soon. Glenville State with the steal and the layup by Erica Tooney. And Glenville State has gone on a 6-0 run here to start off the second quarter. Bailey White with the ball, dribbles through three defenders, gives it to Coleman out front. Coleman dribbles, they're double teaming Coleman. Ball knocked into the backcourt, got it back. Nyjah Anderson with the floater, no good. Rebound by Rollins into the corner for three. Hits it. Bianca White for three. And it's a 27-24 ball game. And Glenville State puts up the three of their own, and she hits it. Brittany Jackson with a three. And they answer right back to UDC's three at the other end. 30-24, Pioneers. Bailey White with the ball. Looks like they're double teaming outside the perimeter if they get a chance to. Nope, just a 3-2 zone at this point. Bailey White puts it up. Correction, Kaya Coleman puts it up. She is fouled. She will go to the line for two. Courtney Davis with the foul for Glenville State. Kaya Coleman at the line for UDC. She is an even 50% free throw shooter on the season. Coleman's first free throw attempt is good. Glenville State subbing in a fresh five coming in to the game, while UDC brings in number 20, Deja Anderson. Sparsely populated crowd here tonight here at UD on the campus of the University of District of Columbia here on Connecticut Avenue. This Rocher. Looks like he was going up, puts up a layup, no good. Ball rolls out of bounds, off of the Pioneers, UDC basketball. We have 7:20 remaining here in the first half, and the Pioneers are up by 4, 30-26. Coach Juan Dixon's club is rebuilding this year on the fly. Showing promising signs right now against a very, very talented Glenville State program. Bianca White reaches in for a foul. I know Juan Dixon has gotta be upset with that. As defenders, you are taught not to reach in for the basketball because the refs will call it every time if they see it. Yes, you may get a steal every now and then, but the fouls will pile up. and that could lead to big trouble later on in the game. Sherry Davis with the ball, passes it over to Paris McLeod. McLeod dribbles in, loses the handle on it. Knocked out of bounds by Naisha Anderson. Pioneers retain the ball. Schrocher with the inbound. Pass out to McLeod. Dribbles in, fires an off-balance shot. Shot clock violation. She put up a very off-balance shot there. As the shot clock was going down, as she had no other choice but to lob it up there and hope for the best. But it's a shot clock violation, and the UDC Firebirds will get the ball underneath the basket. Full court pressure by Glenville State. Naisha Anderson bringing it up behind the back. Double team. She's in a, got to get it away. There she does. A lot of passing by UDC. Gives it out to Naisha Anderson. Double teamed. Kaya Coleman. Naisha Anderson. Dribbles into the lane, puts up a floater, no good off the front iron. Glenville State coming down with the ball, running down the court. Brittany Jackson puts up a three, no good. And the rebound is by Erica Toney and goes and is foul going up. Correction, it was on the floor. Glenville State will inbound under the basket. Coming into the game for the Firebirds, number 11, Diana Tunstall, replacing Kaya Coleman. Pass goes in to Maya Horn. Pass it over to Erica Toney. Pass it back to Horn. Over to Isaiah Smith for three, no good. Rebound by the Pioneers. And stripped away by Bianca White. Bianca White into the corner. Deja Anderson over to Naisha Anderson, who puts up a 25-footer, no good. Rebound by Jadlyn Rollins, who is fouled on the putback. Naisha Anderson with a good rebound there and putting it right back up. She will shoot two. Correction, Jaslyn Rollins is at the line shooting two. Misses the first. Jaslyn Rollins, a senior from Ypsilanti, Michigan, 6'1", is only a 41% free throw shooter on the year. Second one is up, also no good. But taken away, rebound by Deanna Tunstall, and they will get a fresh 30-second shot clock. Bad pass there, knocked away by Jackson. Firebirds will inbound with 22 seconds left on the shot clock. Coming into the game for the Firebirds, number 15, Chantrell Oliver, replacing Diana Tunstall. Chantrell Oliver, senior guard from Columbia, Maryland. Oliver is averaging 10 points per game this season. And they need her the... They need her for some of these points right now. Glenville State foul on number 11, Erica Toney. Pass to Chantrell Oliver, brings it up. Bianca White in the corner. Screened by Rollins. Oliver. To Naisha Anderson for three, and she hits it. 30-29, UDC is only down one. Glenville State puts a three of their own, no good. Scrum in the middle, taken away by Glenville State. Traveling violation on Maya Horn. And UDC will get the basketball back. Media timeout on the floor. 30-29, Glenville State. We will be back after this.
Being an educator is the best job in the world. My philosophy about education is maybe a little bit different. I firmly believe that education is not simply about getting our questions answered. That's probably what we typically think about when we speak about education. There is knowledge, and there is me, and I don't have that knowledge, and so how do I get that knowledge? Well, that certainly is a point. But I think there's an important step before we even can have our questions answered. We must have our answers questioned. That is about questioning what I already think I know. That has to be challenged first. That's probably the most important, the most difficult, but also the most rewarding part of being an educator.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours, the home of Division II college sports.
Welcome back, Firebirds fans. We just had our media timeout. 4:53 left in the game. Glenville State has a slim 30-29 lead over the University of the District of Columbia. Glenville State has been attempting a lot of threes, and they just have not been able to get them to fall. And that is the key, as UDC has been able to stay in this ball game. Aja Anderson, the two Anderson girls, have been putting them on their back. Deja Anderson's shot is no good. Rebound by Glenville State. Coming up the floor, McCloy to the Srocher. Hyanna Stewart with a three, and she hits it. 33-29, Pioneers. Fast break opportunity. Puts up the shot, no good, but she is fouled on the shot. Deja Anderson will go to the line, shooting two. Deja Anderson, a 50% free throw shooter here in the young season. First one is up, rattles around, no good. UC is going to have to capitalize on their free throws if they're going to want to stay close in this one. Puts up the second one, no good as well. Rebound Ridley by Glenville State. As she was saving it, going out of bounds, gave it back to UDC, but couldn't take advantage as Glenville State comes down the court. McCloy stolen away by Deja Anderson. Free fast break layup is good. 33-31, Glenville State. Coach Juan Dixon liking this. He's got to be encouraged by their effort today. And now the Pioneers are starting to make their threes as Cher Davis hits from downtown. 36-31. Broke the press and now puts up a nice scoop shot, no good. Rebound by Rollins, puts it up, and she is fouled. Rollins fouled by Janelle Price of Glenville State. UDC is getting the offensive rebounds and able to get the offensive rebounds and able to put it right back up. Gives them a lot of chances to get to the free throw line and cash in on those opportunities. Even if they don't make the free throws, they're piling up the personal fouls on the Glenville State side. Rollins misses the first. New set of Pioneers coming into the game. Brown puts up the second shot, rattles around and goes. 36-32. UDC down by four here with 3.5 left. Puts up a three off the front iron, no good. Rebound by Chantrell Alver, bringing it up the court. And she wisely likes to bring it out. Cross-court pass to Nia Janderson for three, and she hits it! 36, correction, foot was on the line, 36-34. UDC trails. Maya Horn on the drive, passes it in to Brittany Jackson, puts it up, no good. And she is fouled by Deja Anderson, who is not happy with that call. Nyasia Anderson throwing her hands up in disgust after that one, as she clearly thought she didn't hold her on that, but she is going to take a seat on the bench. First free throw is no good by Brittany Jackson. Brittany Jackson coming into the day is an 85% free throw shooter, so an unlikely miss there. Putting up the second one, and that one is good. 37-34, three-point lead, Glenville State. Trying to trap him in the corner, doesn't work. Gets long pass down to Bianca White, passes it down to Rollins. Gives it to Tunstall. Back to Rollins. Oh, bad pass there, and stolen away by Maya Horn. Easy two-point layup at the other end, 39-34, Glenville State. Sloppy passes are going to give Coach Dixon gray hairs here. Rollins puts up a little jumper, but it is good, 39-36, 2:15 left in the first half. Passes over to the perimeter for Brittany Jackson for three, no good. Rebounded by Nyasia Anderson. Nyasia gets it to Oliver. Oliver brings it down the court. Drives, dishes it out to Diana Tunstall for his three, no good. Rollins with the rebound, puts it up, no good. Fighting in the middle, jump ball. Zeshno will go to the Pioneers. Fresh five coming into the game for Glenville State. Tyra Combs coming into the game for UDC. Her first action of the contest. Pass in to McCloy. Dribbles across half court. Surveys. Gives it up to Cher Davis. Passes it to McCloy. Passes it to Srocher. Up a three in the corner. And she hits it. It's Srocher for three. 6-point lead, Pioneers. Full court press, breaks it. Down the Combs. Drives baseline. Kicks it out. The Nyasia Anderson. Correction, Chantra Oliver. No good. McCloy with the rebound, bringing it back up for the Pioneers. McCloy drives, gives it to Rocher. Passes it out. Gets it. Perimeter. They're giving her space. Takes the drive. No good. Rebound by Combs. Bringing it up as White puts it up for three. No good. It's Rocher with the rebound. Quick shot there. Didn't get time to set it up. It's Rocher for a long three, no good, bounces out. Rebound, Chantro Oliver. Nyasia Anderson gets the ball, brings it up the court. Thinks about it, throws it out to Combs, throws it out to Chantro Oliver, who drives the court, drives in and puts it in. 42-38, 35 seconds left here in the first half. McCoy drives, dishes it out. This is out to Tyann Stewart, puts it up for two, no good. Rebound, stolen away by Nyasia Anderson. Brings it up the court, Chantro Oliver. Over the head of Oliver, and out of bounds. Turnover to Glenville State. ...18.4 seconds left here in the first half. Glenville still letting it roll. Not wasting any time. Picks it up. Passes it to Jackson. Passes it in to Maya Horn. Passes it over to Jackson. Two-pointer no good. Coming down the court. Chantro Oliver puts up the two-pointer and it's good! Chantro Oliver with a layup at the end of the half. And UDC goes into the half, down 42-40 to Glenville State. UDC is hanging in there with Glenville State. 42-40, as UDC is only 10 points away from their season average already here after one half.
The point of the University of the District of Columbia is to allow every individual who walks into our doors to achieve his or her highest level of potential.
It's a melting pot. I grew up in a very diverse country amongst different cultural people, and being at UDC felt like being home.
I think that combination of the international students, and then there's a lot of students here that are coming back to school and their older age, so it's very well-rounded in that way.
So that to be able to combine the quality with the affordability and the diversity makes us something special and unique in higher education. The people that we serve, which are generally DC public school graduates, although we serve students from all over the world and all over the country, part of what has to happen is that they need to see a better place and a better time and a better possibility in their lives, which is why we say that UDC is the place where dreams begin.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
Welcome back, Firebirds fans. I'm your commentator, Brian Bobliss Jr., here live from the campus of the University of the District of Columbia. And we're about ready to get started the second half of this pivotal game, non-conference matchup. Glenville State owns a slim 42-40 lead over University of the District of Columbia. UDC has hung tough with one of the highest scoring teams in the nation in Division II basketball. UDC has hit 3 of 10 three-pointers and has gone only 45% from the line. They're going to have to improve that if they're going to want to keep up the pace. And begin the second half, we have a shot clock violation. Correction, shot clock malfunction. 6 seconds ran off the game clock, but only 3 ran off of the shot clock. But we got it fixed now, and we are ready to resume basketball here in the nation's capital. That's the ball. And she hits it. And we are all tied up here, 42-42. Jackson has the ball, passes it over. Erica Toney. Has it back to Jackson. Out the horn. Give it to Smith. Throw it inside. Off the backboard, no good. Rebound by Rollins. Chantrell Oliver bringing it up the court now for the Firebirds. Pass it over. Gives it to Kaya Coleman. Screen by Rollins. Back over to Oliver. Throws it out to Kaya Coleman for 3. No good. Rebound, Glenville State. Glenville State bringing out the ball. Maya Horn stops, brings it back out. Pass it over for 3. Courtney Davis, and she hits it. 45-42, Pioneers lead by 3. Bad pass by David Anderson there, turned over. Pioneers retain the ball. Coming into the game, 5 more new players for the Pioneers. This is a strategy I have not yet seen in Division II college basketball, or any level of basketball, really. 5 subs coming in all at once. It has to be paying dividends because they're 5-1 and scoring 100 points, almost 100 points per game. So maybe it's something the other teams can look into. Obviously, you can't have 5 subs in when you don't have the players or the talent. So that's a credit to Glenville State's coach. Right there. Now Asia Anderson puts up for two, and it is now a one-point ball game. Gotta give credit to it. Oh, three-point shot by Tyana Stewart, and it's back to a four-point lead. Gotta give credit to Dixon's young rebuilding squad here at UDC. They are putting up a fight. Chantrell Oliver drives the lane and puts it in for two. It's a 48-46. UDC trails 48-46. Out to this Rocher. Pass it over. McLeod. Back. Tyana Stewart puts it up. No good. Rebound. Nyasia Anderson. Handed off. Coming down to the court. Deja Anderson. Thought about it. Going back out. Giving it to Oliver. Passing into the corner. Clyde Coleman for three. No good. Rebound by Rollins. Nice pass underneath to Coleman, and it's up and good. Tie score, 48 apiece. 48 apiece here, 7 minutes left in the third quarter. Pass to Frozier, goes to Trussell, back to McLeod. Deep three, no good. Rebound by Rollins. Rollins passes out to Anderson. And a silly foul by the Glenville State, Tyana Stewart, reaching in. Actually, it might not have been too bad of a foul because she had a breakaway layup if not for Tyana Stewart and her reach-in foul. UDC possession, 6 minutes, 50 left to go, 60, 48 all. Coleman drives, dishes it back out to Oliver. Oliver looking for some space, can't find it. Rollins sets the pick, sends it over. Coleman, back to Oliver. Drives the lane, and she gets tripped up. And there's a foul called on Glenville State. And they will inbound under the basket. Coming into the game for your Firebirds, number 10, Bianca White. And coming out is number 5, Nyasia Anderson. Coleman passes it over. Kayla Cooper, first action of the day for Cooper. Outside the three-point line, Cooper puts it up for three, no good. Rebound by Glenville State. Coming down the court, Maya Horn, two. Tries again, down low, too long. Turnover, Firebirds possession. New five coming into the game for Glenville State. Coming into the game for the Firebirds, Diana Tunstall coming in for Jasmine Rollins. Rollins has been huge today in getting all of those rebounds. They're gonna miss her presence down low. Crossing the midcourt line, giving it to Cooper. Back out to Deja Anderson, back out to Coleman. Double teamed out by the Firebirds logo, gets out of it. Brings it up to the three-point line. 8 seconds left, she's gotta get a hold of it, and she gets bailed out. Kaya Coleman gets bailed out by number 0, Odyssey Trussell of Glenville State. And UDC will get a fresh 30-second shot clock. I understand you want to put pressure on the opposing team, but you cannot allow that so far from the basket with only about 5 seconds left in the shot clock. Coleman dribbles in, passes it out. Good pass, back to Coleman for two, no good. Ball bounds away. And it will be Glenville State ball. New five coming in for Glenville State. UDC playing a 2-3 zone. Glenville State deserves the horn. Back to Jackson for three, no good. Picked up by Deja Anderson. Anderson, go to Coleman. Coleman Bianca White in the corner for three, no good. Rebound by Courtney Davis. Throwing it up the horn. Into the corner for Isaiah Smith. She goes over to Jackson. And there's a holding foul underneath. And we will have a media timeout. 48-48 all here at UDC, 5 minutes left. I'm Brian Robles Jr. We'll be right back right after this.
As an integral part of the University of the District of Columbia, the Department of Intercollegiate Athletics provides experiences that enhance the comprehensive development of our student athletes. With a commitment to excellence, we embrace the overall mission of the NCAA with an emphasis on Division II to provide growth opportunities through academic achievement, learning in high-level athletic competition, and development of positive societal attitudes in service to community. In addition, we are committed to providing a game environment which respects fairness, courtesy, and ethical conduct towards others. We are the University of the District of Columbia, an advanced public system of higher learning where dreams begin.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Back live here on the campus of the University of the District of Columbia. 48-48 all here, 5 minutes left in the third quarter. Glenville State has come in red hot, averaging about 98 points per game, but the young Firebirds have kept it close and are playing inspired basketball. UDC foul, number 21, Jaslyn Rollins. And Courtney Davis will go to the line, shooting two for Glenville State. Davis puts it up, and it's good. Davis coming into the day only 40% on the free throw line. Makes her first. Courtney puts it up. Correction, hasn't put it up yet. Puts it up now, and she makes both. 50-48, Glenville State leads. Nia Anderson coming down the court. Pass it to Chantrell Oliver. Oliver. Waiting for something to open up. Rollins picks. Pick and roll. Oliver takes it herself. Puts it up. No good. Back up for Rollins. No good as well. And rebounded by Isaiah Smith. Coming down is Maya Horn. Gives it back to Horn. Over to Isaiah Smith. Down to Brittany Jackson. Brittany Jackson drives, puts it up. No good, off the iron. Rebound, Nyasia Anderson. Anderson gets it over to Oliver. Oliver passing midcourt. Oliver looking for a setup. Glenville State playing 2-3 zone. Oliver passes it inside. Nice pass to Deja Anderson, but can't finish. Nyasia Anderson tried stealing it back away, but no luck. Glenville State retains the ball. Glenville State bringing in another five players. Coming into this game that Glenville State took a lot of threes, and there's another one, doesn't fall, rebound by Glenville State, picked up, lost by Deja Anderson, picked up, going down the court is Nyasia Anderson, and she brings it back out, and Oliver will restart. But Glenville State has put up a lot of threes, and they've made a fair share of them, but they put up so many threes that UDC has been able to take advantage of it on the boards. Central Oliver into the corner, gives it to Bianca White, puts it up, and it's good! Bianca White with a layup, and we are tied at 50 all. Coming down the court, Paris McCloy, throws it over, gives it to Tyana Stewart, passes it out to the Schrocher, back to McCloy, going over, Odyssey Trussell for three, and she hits it. 53-50, Pioneers lead. Deja Anderson, pass it over. Chantrell Oliver, setting up the offense. Gives it over to Bianca White, gives it back over. Chantrell Oliver, Oliver passes. Nyasia Anderson, back up to Deja Anderson, back to Nyasia. Gives it out to Chantrell Oliver for three from the corner, no good. Rebound by Stewart. Paris McCloy brings it up. Gives it to Schrocher. In the corner for three, no good. Rebounded by McCloy. Gives back out to Schrocher, passes back out to Trussell. And Stewart, Stewart for three, no good. Rebound by McCloy, no good. And we got a scrum. And we have a foul. We have a hold on UDC. Looks like a clean trap there. Nonetheless, I'm not the one making the calls up here. And the refs saw fit that it was a hold. Glenville State basketball. Jocelyn Rollins coming out. Coming in for UDC, Kaya Coleman. And number 22, Tyra Combs. McCloy passes it back in. McCloy taking her time up top. UDC has been able to hold the Glenville State offense in check today as an offense that scores almost 97 points per game is being held to 53 here late in the third quarter. 3 second violation on Glenville State. Turnover, UDC basketball. Glenville State's been making a couple careless mistakes here underneath the basket, and it could prove costly here late in this game. The longer the young UDC Firebirds hang around, the more chance they have to pull off a sizable upset. Kaya Coleman passes it out. Bianca White passes to Coleman. Coleman dribbles. 10-foot floater, no good. Out of bounds off of Glenville State. Inbound underneath the basket. Coleman, looking for an open woman. And we got a push here on Glenville State. Number 32, Brittany Jackson. Fourth team foul on Glenville State. They've got to be careful. One more and UDC goes into the bonus for the quarter. Out to Combs. Gives it back to Coleman. Coleman waiting for the offense to develop. Gives it out to Bianca White. White cuts through the lane and she hits it. Nice floater cutting in there by Bianca White. And it's 53-52, Pioneers lead, only by one. Jackson gives it over to McCloy. Back out to Jackson. Puts it up, and the shot. Foul before the shot. Foul on Kaya Coleman. No, the foul was during the shot. Continuation play, I believe. Brittany Jackson will go to the line, shooting two. Brittany Jackson, their best free throw shooter, coming into the game. 85% from the stripe. First one is good. 2-point lead, Glenville State. Jackson puts up the second one. And that is also good. 4-point lead for Glenville State here with 50 seconds remaining in the third. Bianca White takes it, gives it out to Coleman. Coleman passes it in Anderson. Back out to Coleman. Holds it. Waiting for something. Stolen away by McCloyd. And she will hold it. And there is only 2 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Glenville State looks like they're going to hold it until the final seconds here and try and get the final shot off of the third quarter. McCloyd out the horn. Back to McCloyd. Gives it over. Brittany Jackson. Back over the horn. Back to McCloyd. They're just playing keep away now. Jackson, they got to shoot now. 4, 3, 2. McCloyd puts it up. No good, but she is fouled. She is fouled on the shot. Foul by number 11, Deanna Tunstall. And McCloyd will go to the line for the Pioneers. McCloyd, their leading scorer coming into the game, averaging 17 points per game, has been fairly quiet in the points category today, but she has been able to lead the offense. First shot is up, and it is good. Yeah, McCloyd is coming into the halftime was only 1 of 8 from the floor, so she has not been her usual self today, but she has still been the floor general that the Pioneers have needed. 57-52, made 1 of 2. Coleman cannot get the shot. Kaya Coleman going down to try and get a last second shot was fouled with almost no time left on the clock. They had maybe 0.2 seconds left on the clock when she was fouled. As the clock ran out, they gave her a foul on Glenville State. It looks like Coleman's going to get 2 free throws here. Coleman, only a 50% free throw shooter, puts it up, and no good. After this free throw, it will be the end of the third quarter. Coleman puts it up and cannot make either. That's a tough break for UDC, as they could have gotten 2 freebies there at the end of the third quarter and shrink the lead to a 1-possession game. At the end of the third quarter, with your score, Glenville State Pioneers 57 and your UDC Firebirds 52.
Building an advanced public system of higher learning that serves the community of the District of Columbia. We selected all of those words very carefully because they all have important meanings. Because none of it really works unless you have a public higher education system that can connect it all together. Well, one of the best kept secrets about the University of the District of Columbia is that we have many quality programs. Our workforce development unit is of a high quality and puts people in jobs each and every day. Our land grant unit, which is serving constituents all over the district. We're the only urban land grant institution in the country. I think that we have all the pieces that we can put together in a way that will allow us to take best practices, best tools, and really wipe the slate clean and redesign ourselves as a advanced public system of higher learning that can serve the district in a way that allows us to be a model of higher education in a city that wants to be a model city for the rest of the country.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub. with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
UDC fans, we're here live in the nation's capital as Glenville State is taking a 57-52 lead. Here at the start of the fourth quarter. Clock malfunction. Got corrected right away, and we are ready to go here from University of the District of Columbia. I'm Brian Bobbles Jr., and very glad to have you join us here today. Horn takes it up. Passes over to McCloy. McCloy goes around center court, gives it back to Horn. Almost stolen away. Gets back up to McCloy. Passes inside. Gets it back out to McCloy, who dribbles, takes a shot, and it's good. 59-52. McCloy starting to heat up a little bit. Chantrell Oliver, down to Nyasia. Nyasia out to Bianca White for three, and she hits it. Bianca White with a three from the corner, 59-55. Stewart, moving to Horn. Horn, out to McCloy. First year coach Kim Stevens over there at Glenville State getting animated, and McCloy hits another three. McCloy is starting to heat up for the Pioneers. Oliver, over to Nyasia. Nyasia puts it up, and she is fouled, and she will go to the line for one. Nyasia Anderson went to the bucket and dropped a little floater in there. 62-57, UDC trails by five. Nyasia Anderson goes to the line to try and close the gap to a four-point lead, four-point deficit. Nyasia is 66% free throw shooter on the year. Shot is up, and it is good. 62-58. Firebirds down by four. Isaiah Smith takes it out, gives it back to Horn. Horn dribbles out to midcourt. Gives it over to Brittany Jackson. Jackson, the Horn. Horn, waiting for something. Gives it out to Jackson. Gives it to Tony. Tony turns it over. Firebirds will get the ball. Glenville State has been relentless in this full court pressure. The UDC has been able to break it every single time. UDC has shown poise in breaking the full court press. But then sloppy turnover there in their offensive zone. Brittany Jackson for three, no good. Ooh. Glenville State just had a little spill over there. As Isaiah Smith, as she was going for the basketball near her own bench, went flying into Odyssey Trussell. Looks like the two women are okay though, which is always good to see. Stewart brings it over. Gives it to Horn. Passes it into the corner. Brittany Jackson, and she hits a three. That's a big three-pointer as against Pioneers, a seven-point lead. Tyana Stewart with the foul. Four players coming into the game for the Pioneers. Tyra Combs coming into the game also for the University of the District of Columbia. 65-58, Glenville State leads here with 7:45 left remaining in regulation. Chantrell Oliver brings it up past the Firebirds logo. Gives it out. Bianca White dribbles over. Gives it back to Oliver. And she traveled. Chantrell Oliver with the traveling violation. Something the young Firebirds will have to clean up going forward this season if they want to have a chance at the East Coast Conference title. This game may not mean anything in the East Coast Conference standings, but it's huge for a young Firebird squad to be able to see that they can hang with one of the best teams in the country. It's Rocher with a three-pointer and is up to a 10-point lead. First double-digit lead for Glenville State in a while, and a turnover, and Glenville State with another easy layup, 70-58, Pioneers lead. Coach Dixon with a timeout as the game may be starting to slip away from the young UDC Firebirds. Glenville State, 70-58, here on the campus of UDC. We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back, UDC fans, as your UDC Firebirds are trailing 12 here as they've made a couple young mistakes. I've used the word young a lot here with this Firebirds club, but they only have two seniors on this squad. Juan Dixon, first year coach Juan Dixon, held a very young club, and it's starting to show right now as they are committing some costly turnovers. Rebound, jump ball. Jump ball. Possession arrow, Glenville State. Come in. Looking for an inbound, gets it in to Kaya Coleman. Trapped in the corner, gets it out. Chantrell Oliver throws it down court. They got numbers. Nyjah Anderson puts it up, and she is fouled. I think the wear and tear is starting to show on these Firebirds, as Glenville State has been continuously the entire game bringing in five subs at a time. And you can kind of tell that Glenville State is still fresh, while UDC is starting to wear down from the grind of a four-quarter basketball game. As I speak, five more Pioneers come onto the court. Asia Anderson made the first shot, going up for her second now. Asia puts it up. Off the front iron, no good. Rebound, Glenville State. Jump ball, possession, Pioneers. UDC is about to utilize full court press. Gets the horn in the corner, trapped, stolen away. Nyjah Anderson picks it up, layup, no good, but she is fouled. Glenville State foul, number one, Maya Horn. Nyjah Anderson will go to the line, shooting two more. Asia Anderson has really kept this team in it. Asia puts it up. And then no good. Asia Anderson has been a key cog in this UDC Firebirds offensive attack. As she has over 20 points today. En route to leading the Firebirds. Asia puts it up, rattles around and goes. 70 to 60. 10-point lead for Glenville State. McCloy brings it up, gives it over to Horn, passes it over. Gives it to Jackson in the corner for three, no good. Rebound by Courtney Davis, puts it up and good. 72 to 60. UDC trails. Oliver brings it down, gives it to Coleman, Coleman in the corner. Brings it out, gives it to Oliver. Oliver over to Nyjah Anderson for three, hits it. Nyjah Anderson stays red hot as it is now a 9-point basketball game. Brittany Jackson open for three in the corner, no good. Rebound by Courtney Davis. It's up and it is good. Courtney Davis with the and one. She will go to the line shooting one. There is a mental lapse there by the Firebirds. On that rebound, there were three blue shirts going around the ball while there was only one Firebird down there for the rebound. Dixon's squad's going to have some growing pains here in his first year in the helm. But just showing that they can stick with a 5-1 team that's averaging 97 points a game has got to give him some confidence going forward. McLeod up, and it's good. 77-63 as the Pioneers are starting to pull away here late. Firebirds need a spark in any way. Oliver. Get point out the Russians. Rollins with the pick. Oliver passes it to Coleman. Coleman from the baseline, drew the jumper, no good. Rollins with the rebound, puts it back up, no good. Rollins goes for it again, out of bounds. Rebound by McLeod. McLeod bringing it up, 5 minutes remaining here on the campus of the University of DC. 77-63, Pioneers lead. McLeod for a deep three, no good. Holding foul on Glenville State. Coach Kim Stevens is not happy about that. Timeout on the floor here at UDC. Glenville State up 77-63 over University of DC. We will be right back after these messages.
One of the issues that I have particular interest in is mentoring women of color. A lot of the research in higher education has looked at issues with men, particularly African American men, and their persistence to graduation from college. But the data support that young women, particularly minority women, are at greater risk for dropping out of school, and if they leave school, the likelihood that they will return is much lower than the likelihood of a minority male's return to school. So we really have to do some concrete and sustainable kinds of efforts around shoring up our most vulnerable college students. And while we've spent a lot of time looking at men and minority men, the data support that minority women are probably at greater risk, not of getting to college. They'll get to college probably in higher number, but they're at greater risk of completing.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's will you.
Thank you. Welcome back. This is Brian Bobliss Jr. live from the campus of the University of the District of Columbia, where UDC trails here 63-77 with 4:50 left remaining in the game. Central Oliver at the line shooting two. Oliver makes the first. Oliver coming into the day a 71% free throw shooter and averaging about 10 points per game. Puts up the second shot. Rims out, no good. Cloyd, bring it up for the Pioneers. Pioneers slowing down the pace a little bit. They got a lead. They're gonna try and milk that shot clock for all it's worth. McCoyd, over the horn. Out the Disrosier. Out the horn. Disrosier for three, no good. Foul on the floor. On UDC's Deja Anderson. That's a killer right there. UDC could have gotten the ball back, but instead, Glenville State gets a full 30-second shot clock. Every second is crucial here. UDC starting to run out of time. They're going to need to start going on a run here shortly. Overthrow of UDC. Correction, Glenville State's able to run it down. Glenville State, despite being up 13 points, is still launching some threes. Gets it down low. Courtney Davis for two, and it's good. 15-point lead for the Pioneers. As I was saying, Glenville State's been still putting up a good amount of threes, even though they're up 15 points. Oliver takes it in, gives it out to White for three, no good. Rebound by the Pioneers, Horn. Out the horn. Horn taking it up. Out the McCloy. Turning around. Stewart. Back out the McCloy. Killing some clock. 11 seconds left in the play clock. Shot clock. Play clock is football. McCloy for three. No good. Rebound. Aja Anderson. Anderson pushes it up the floor. Takes it in. And there is a charge. Called on Nyasia Anderson. I'm not so sure that Glenville State set their feet there. Nonetheless, it is a charge. And Glenville State will get the basketball. UDC kept it close for the first three quarters of this game, but the sheer offensive output of Glenville State has been too much for the young Firebirds to be able to keep up with. McCloy, nice scoop shot, no good. Puts it back up, no good. Rebound, Deja Anderson. Anderson brings it up the court. Layup. No good, Birds back up, no good, but it's fouled. Glenville State foul on number 10, Courtney Davis. Deja Anderson will go to the line shooting two. Deja is only a 50% free throw shooter on the season. Puts it up, no good. Missed free throws are killing the Firebirds here down the stretch. Second shot up. And it is good. 14-point lead for Glenville State. UDC is going into a full court press mode. Starting to get in desperation mode here with 14 points down, 2.5 minutes left. And we have a foul on UDC, Bianca White. Still only their fourth foul of the quarter. A So they've been able to at least limit them. Horn takes it up, passes it deep. The slow shoot gets it, passes it back out, settling it down. 2:15 left in the ball game. UDC down 14 points. McCoy goes in, gives it to the Strocher for the three from the baseline. No good. Rebound, Brittany Jackson. Jackson called for the charge. She lowered her shoulder. Might have had a little bit of a flop going on there. Good acting by UDC. As Brittany Jackson put her shoulder down. And UDC gave the referee something to look at, and they were rewarded with a charging call. Bianca White passes it out to Oliver. Oliver brings across midcourt. Chantra Oliver for three, no good. Rebound by Rollins. Kicks it back out to Naija Anderson for three. No good as well. And it will be Pioneer's ball. That lady isn't singing yet, but she sure is warming up the pipes. As a 14-point lead with a minute 37 left against a team as offensively gifted as Glenville State might just be the death knell for this UDC team. You've got to give Lon Dixon's club credit, though, to come in here and fight so hard, given the talent level of Glenville State. But UDC's inexperience may cost them here. Aisha Anderson brings it down the floor. Layup is good. 79-67. 1 minute remaining in the contest. And Deja Anderson knocks it out of bounds off of a Pioneers player. And it may be too little too late. And it's 79-67 with 56 seconds left here in regulation. Oliver brings it up, swings it out. Bianca White brings it back in. Rollins can't handle it, brings it back out, gives it to Deja Anderson, drives the court, puts it out. Chantra Oliver for three, and she hits it. Chantra Oliver for three, 9-point game, and it's stolen. Correction, as a big pile. Chantra Oliver comes up with it. Chantra Oliver puts up a three, no good. Rebound. Aisha Anderson puts it up for two, and a foul. Aisha Anderson gets the and one, and it's now a 7-point game with 23 seconds left. Don't count these Firebirds out too soon, folks. I may have spoke too soon. UDC is mounting comeback here. 23 seconds left. Aisha Anderson at the line shooting one. Is it up? Off the front iron, no good. Rebound by by Tyana Stewart. And they are in the bonus. Glenville State will shoot free throws. Coming into the game for UDC, number three, Kaya Coleman. Local product of St. Vincent Pilate High School, down the road a bit in Laurel, Maryland. Tanya Stewart puts it up, and it's good. 80-72. Glenville State is on top. Tiana Stewart puts up second one, and it's good. Their best free throw shooter coming through when needed the most. Their second best free throw shooter, excuse me. 81-72. Andrew Oliver drives, keeps it inbound. Nice play. Naija Anderson puts up a two, no good. Jalen Rollins puts it up, and she is fouled. Jalen Rollins going to the line for two. 81 72, UDC down by 9. Rollins puts it up, and it's good. Rollins, a 41% free throw shooter coming into today. Eight-point lead for Glenville State. And it's up and good, Jasmine Rollins. 81-74. Horn dribbles it out, gets it down to Tyama Stewart. And that's about the, and that's the end of this ball game, folks. As a great effort by Juan Dixon's young UDC Firebirds squad is to no avail as they drop this game to the Glenville State Pioneers by a score of 81-74. Juan Dixon's club's defense has got to be praised in the locker room after this game, as he held a very, very potent Pioneers offense to only 81 points today, 16 points underneath of their average for this season. Juan Dixon's got to take all the positives out of this game, move forward, and take it in with momentum to their East Coast Conference schedule. I'm Brian Bubbles Jr. signing off today as your... as your UDC Firebirds fall 74-81 to Glenville State.